Hey everybody, welcome back to Skylanders SWAP Force for the 3DS. In the last part, we went to the woods and saved some forest spirits from some polluted areas, and in this part, we're gonna head back to the woods, a different area of the woods, and find Persephone, like Flint suggested in the last part. Alright, let's talk to him real quick.
How's it flying? What's our next stop?
Okay, you can actually see her in the picture of the world. Alright, and this level here is Ancient Woods. And if you missed the last episode, we couldn't get to that sneak swap zone because there aren't any sneak ones out yet, so that'll have to be taken care of another time. Okay, let's head to level 2 of World 2, Toadstool Terrace. Okay. Right now I'm playing as Riptide, who is one of the new core Skylanders in this game. Core meaning he doesn't swap. But he's actually a really cool character. As you can see, he uses a swordfish to attack. But what's cool is he has like combo attacks with his primary attack. Then if you switch to his secondary attack with the X button, he throws a swordfish and uses a hammerhead shark, which is actually different because it moves slower, but it's more powerful. So you actually get a couple different options with him. And there's probably... he probably has more attacks once you start upgrading him. I used him a little bit in my other file, but I forgot to save his data, so he started back at level 1. Okay, let's take out these two robot guys. Oh, yeah, in this level, there's some really, really nice looking areas. I'll switch back to the sword. Yeah, when he throws the hammerhead shark, he tosses it up in the air. Unlike the swordfish, he throws that like straight forward. Okay, this is a really cool area. If you are playing with the 3D on, like that little, those little particles in the air, actually like, you know, pop out, which actually looks very cool. The only thing is, since the 3DS capture device doesn't record like 3D, like any 3D effects, you guys won't see it, but if you get the game, or if you have the game, then you'll see it. Okay, there's nothing really else in here, so let's get out. Hey, there's plenty of these enemies here, the beetles with the buzzsaws on their heads. These were in the last level, and they're, like I said, they're everywhere. Yeah, so far, Riptide, even though he's starting out, he's actually pretty strong. It's actually a very interesting character. I think it's cool that he uses a fish to slap enemies around. Or slash them, I should say. Okay, I don't think I missed anything. Yeah, but yeah, it's cool that, you know, Persephone's in here. Because, you know, she's not in the console version. So it's cool that, you know, characters that... you know, that they cut from the console version of Swap Force are in this version. And they play a role in this version. Okay, here's the water challenge. It's basically some platforming. So I'm gonna get rid of this flower here. There you go. That thing's just gonna keep attacking you if you don't hit it. Okay, there we go. Oh, shoot. I should have double jumped there. Oh, wait. Not everything came back. See if I can make it. Yeah. Okay, and we have a few enemies here and a hat. Let's take care of these guys real quick. I should level up very soon. Yep, there we go. New upgrade. Let's see here. Wrath of the Whale. Hold Y to summon a massive whale. Oh, I have to do this. Whoa! That is cool. I can't wait to use that on some enemies. Let's see that again. That's awesome. I thought he'd throw it out like... who does it? Chill? She throws out the narwhal. as her soul gem in the console version. But now he just uses this giant well. It's actually really cool because he gets it so early. He's only level 3 and he got this attack already. It seems like it's powerful too. Oh, this part is neat. Like when you jump off them, they spin around. Yeah, one thing I noticed about this game is compared to the previous 3DS ones, like the production value is a lot higher. Like they have a lot of voice acting, and the environments they look better, I think, in this game compared to previous ones. You know, giants compared to the first game, giants had like bigger levels, but I think these ones are even more so. Oh wait, let's slap him with a whale. Oof. Oh wait, did I miss? Okay, well I think those fish that come out of it, they attack too. Yeah, they do. See? Huh. That attack is even more powerful than I thought it was. So not only do you summon a whale, you summon some fish that track enemies for you. This guy is fun. I actually didn't know he had that attack. When I was playing with the figure earlier in my other file, just to play through this level first, I didn't know he had that attack. Okay, we need an air Skylander. Let's see. Let's summon a giant. Let's summon Swarm. There's an air gate, and there's also a gate for the Tornado or Twister one. We'll go to both of them. Let's go to this one first, though. It's actually really cool, because in Skylanders Giants for the 3DS, when you use the giant, everybody can run. It doesn't matter if they're a giant or not, but everybody can run. And it's really cool because, some of the giants are like really slow moving in the console version, but on the 3DS, they can actually move really quickly. So I always thought that was cool. I think their jumping is not that great, but I was able to make it. Okay, there's another hat for us. Okay, and then in here, I'll switch to another Skylander. This one requires one with the tornado bottom. I can't remember what it's called offhand. Now let's swap. Let's see, what should I make? Well, I definitely have to have this bottom, or the legendary version. Let's see. That seems interesting. Let's see, blast zone, firecracker. Yeah, let's do this. This would be Fire Ranger. Yeah, that's pretty silly. Okay, so let's go in. Alright, so this is like the previous one. I think the one in the first level, we have to use the spin powers to deflect projectiles. You're going to have to do that here, too. Oh, wait, no, you know what? No, never mind. I'm sorry. You're going to have to use the power at least, but it's a different thing. I remember this now. There we go. Get some of that health back. Okay, you're going to see what you have to do with the tornado here, but you probably guess from that. Very cool. And another thing I like about this game is they really use the swap powers in the swap zones like really well, because in the console version, I like how you go through different mini games like for the speed ones, you go through like a race course. And then for like the teleport ones, you go through that like grid puzzle type thing. And then in this version, you use them to go through like, they're all like platforming parts for the most part, but they're all utilized in a really cool way. There we go. And here's the next flower. Alright, there we go, and spin this up. Oops, oh, you have to hold it in. I thought you could just tap it, but there you go. Oh, and there's the hat. I think we might get attacked by enemies up here. I know, but there's a treasure chest. Okay, that's number 3 out of 7. Let's see what the objectives are. I didn't really check. Okay, collect coins. We did the two elemental gates. Swap zone, we're almost done with this one. Then bash chests. Okay. Let's keep moving forward. Oh, I didn't even see that guy there. Get out of here. Okay, and Fire Ranger. I almost called him Free Ranger. Fire Ranger's out there. I was about to say, he's about to level up, but he just did. Yeah, these things are just so annoying. Okay, let's go over here. It seems like there's stuff over here, too. Oh, another treasure chest. Good, good. That's number four? Yep. Okay, let's switch again. Let's see, let's use night shifts top, and then the bottom, let's see. That's like the same. How about night jet? that's a pretty interesting combination there. Okay, but yeah, that makes him pretty fast. But then again, well, on the console version at least, Night Shift is actually already fast because of that teleport thing. Oops. His attack is interesting. Let's see what his other attack is. Oh, the bite. Okay, so he has like the same attacks as on the console version, at least right now. The punches and then the vampire bite. There we go. Okay. I'll probably switch back to him later, but we do have to switch here. Let's use Nitro Magna Charge. Yeah, there's... Freeze Blade is not out yet, as of this video, so... The only, like, speed boost guys that I have are the two Magna Charges. Okay, and this is actually really fun, too. Although, when I did this the first time, I actually got hit a lot. But the speed power you can utilize to slow it, like, slows down time. The description said, like, it looks like time's being slowed down, but you're just moving really fast. So, but in the game, you're pretty much just slowing down time. Now, something else I noticed that is really cool is the two magnet charges, the blaster move they have. In the console version, it overheats eventually. In the 3DS version, you can just rapid fire until it stops, which takes a while, and then you can charge up that missile. There you go. So yeah, he's really good. Needless to say. Okay, let's use that. Whoa. Alright, there we go. Now we have to deal with these enemies, but they shouldn't be too bad. That guy did, he just took like a couple steps forward. You're done. Okay, he got a little close, but the blaster saved me. Okay, I'm just making sure I didn't miss anything here. But we're not done in the area yet. There's a lot more like speed boost areas, I think. I know there's one towards the end that gets kinda tricky. That's the one I almost died in last time. Number 5. Now right here. See how fast that's moving? I mean, of course you slow it down, but you have to time it right. You also want to make sure you hit those zippers, I guess. They call them that in Mario Kart. There we go. So you can replenish your speed. Right, we got two friends here. Move away. This area isn't as big as the last one. There we go. Okay, and that's it. Okay, we have a left and a right side. This side has a treasure chest. Or 6 out of 7. I hope I didn't miss one. Oh, you know what? I think there's going to be one on the right side there. Yep. Okay, and we're done with that. Actually, let's see. Okay, I got everything. Now we just have to do the time challenge. Let's hit in. Oh, okay. We have to do this first, but this should be easy. Okay, if you've played the previous games in the series on the console, you probably remember these lock puzzles. These are not in Swap Force on the consoles, but they're in the 3DS one. So if you miss those, then they're here. But these are a little different, because you're not collecting things as the little lock guy. You're just trying to get them out. Okay, and then the key just kind of appears there. Okay. I think this should be the end here. Let's see. Oh no, not quite yet. Okay. You know, how much time do they give you in the time show? Oh, 5 minutes? That should be good. Because, you know, we're not going to stop for, like, the collectibles anymore, so. I think 5 minutes is manageable. He's just so good in this game. That blaster is, like, super strong. Okay, for this final part, I'm gonna switch, let's see, go back to that combination I was using before. Is it night shift, and then, yeah, boom jet, okay, night jet. Yeah, this combination is pretty neat. Oh, you can, okay. Looks like I launched the hoverboard, huh. Whoa, that's cool. Oh, that heals you too. Well, he's really good too, the top half. Yeah, you bite them once and then actually continues attacking them and healing you too, it seems like. So that's cool. Okay, yeah, this is the end of the level right here.
Lucky party! Persephone is happy to see you, Skylander. Cages of unhappy design. Please, Skylander, with Mana Bomb, release me from sad cage.
Okay, same voice actress as before, but yeah, Persephone is known for the upgrade system in the previous games. Whoa. I forgot that those were timed. Okay. But anyway, let's free her.
Thank you, Skylander, for removal of unhappy cage. Here is bright and smooth and happy to dance. But no happy dancing will be had. Sister fairies removed from old place in unhappy cages. Most happy magic drained, but Skylander helpful. Dance at Fountain Springs. Persephone will help Skylander remove unhappy cages. Fairy sisters will be free for more happy dancing.
Okay, and that's it. Okay, so we did get everything that we could get in that level, and then we also unlocked the time challenge, so we're gonna do that after, you know, we go through all these screens. And then there's also a conversation at the end of this too. Hopefully I found all the halves. There should be four here. The four winds hat looks weird. An awesome hat. If you want to be number one, you wear that hat. Yep, that's everything.
Great! Welcome back, Perception. I mean, Perspiration. I mean, hi.
No time for happy hellos. Sisters are in very bad trouble. sad machine is draining all the color and happiness from the forest. Sister fairies all caught, all put in unhappy cages. Please, Skylander, rescue sisters and make the forest happy again.
A magic draining machine in the forest? That sounds like just the lead we're looking for.
Well, it sounds to me like you need a big, strong, incredibly handsome hero type to save you from this mechanical monster. And I'm just the guy.
Sad, unhappy day. Sisters lost in a cold, crying place. No happy dances to be had until they return.
Okay. So we're going to head back to the previous level and do the time challenge.
Hey there, buddy. Where are we off to?
Okay, then after that we have another level here, Fountain Springs. And then we have another level after that. Then we can move on to the next world. Fountain Springs. Okay, good. There's no sneak in that one, too. Okay, let's head in and do the time challenge. Alright, let's skip that. Okay, but I'm also gonna switch here. Okay, here we go. Let's go with Stump Smash. I don't remember if he's like incredibly slow, but if he is... No, he's not that slow. I was gonna say, I could switch him out if I need to. Okay, well, good to know that he takes out those guys in one hit. I did unlock an upgrade, let's see. Oh, the charge attack, okay. That might not be as useful here because, you know, you're kind of strapped for time. It takes quite a few hits for him to take out those guys right now. There we go. Okay, this should be pretty straightforward. There aren't many parts here that, you know, require like a lot of time. You can pretty much just run through most of these areas. I think the only parts are like the platforming areas. But those weren't too bad the first time through. Okay, there we go. Now we have an enemy gate here, but these guys are easy. Yeah, that combo attack's actually really powerful. Oh, I forgot, he has another attack too. Spits out the acorns. I like poisons them too. If you notice, he was taking damage after I spit them out, so that is actually pretty helpful as well. If you poison enemies and then attack them with your hammer combos, I'd imagine that does a lot of damage. Okay, a lot of the Skylanders are leveling up pretty quickly. His jumping ability isn't the best, but it's good enough to get through like certain parts here. Oop, time. There we go. Okay, now that we're on a new island, switch. Who do I want to be? I still have to scan in some of the other Skylanders. As you can see, I've scanned in a bunch, but not everybody quite yet. Let's go with Voodood. Okay, I actually can't quite remember how he attacks in 3DS ones. Okay, he has the axe combo. Oh, it's pretty much the same way. He has the grappling axe. Trying to take some of these enemies here for extra time. Some of them have been dropping some too. But otherwise, they're good, still good for experience points. Okay, it's hard to see those guys sometimes. They kind of blend in. Yep, there's one right there. Yeah, I thought that, not the one I just killed, but the one before that was like a coin. So it went up to it, that's why he like ran right into me. There we go. Like I said in the previous video, for if you're trying to get 100% in levels, it's best to do it in the regular mission instead of the time challenge, because since you're strapped for time, you have to go through level quickly, and those swap zones and elemental gates are pretty much just a distraction. Okay, you're still timed here, but what's interesting is every time... Oh wait, no, this timer still goes down, never mind. That one's easy. That might be pretty annoying later on in the game when they probably put up more complex puzzles than that. Okay, jeez, I was like, why isn't that opening up? Okay, we still have a little bit to go. And I have a little over 2 minutes. Man, that guy can give me a clock. Okay, at least Voodood leveled up. Yeah, I'm not sure if there's clocks hidden in those acorns. I haven't been checking them, that's why. But, hopefully not. It makes more sense if they come from the enemies. There we go. Oh! That was... Oh, there's another clock. Nice. Okay, we're getting there. Actually, no, we are here. That's it. Yeah. Alright, let's skip this. Just free here with the mana bomb. Again, that's it. That was actually pretty easy. Got down close to the 2 minute mark, but those clocks that we picked up along the way, they really helped out. Okay, and we are completely done with that level. Oh, new upgrade, Voo Dash. Press Y. Oh, that's cool. Alright, let's go back to Boomtown. Okay, like it said at that info screen, on the 3DS version, like if you collect experience points and stuff like that, you want to make sure that you resummon the Skylander, because what it does, it updates the data to the figure. It's not like the console versions where you have to have the figure on the portal at all times and it auto-updates like automatically for you. You have to do it manually. Just something to keep in mind. Okay. But yeah, in the next video we'll head to Fountain Springs, and that's pretty much it for this one. Alright, thanks for watching everybody. See you next time.